is that really today people are preaching about these being the end of time. And it is not absolutely true, untrue, depending on how you view the world. Because the world that we live in today is a world that has been constructed by white power of the misery and at the expense of Africans and other peoples around the world. When they talk about the end of time coming because they see crisis and chaos, what appears as chaos to them is actually people struggling and challenging the relationship that they have to white power and to imperialism. So it is a tremendous threat. Here you have a place, they didn't think of it as the end of time. When they came to the Americas and kicked off a process of killing the indigenous population here, maybe 98% of all the so-called Indians were wiped out. But they didn't, the white people did not see it as the end of time. Europeans did not perceive this occurrence as something representing the end of time. In fact, for them, it was a new beginning, wasn't it? It was like the beginning of their leap into history. The same thing is true in general in terms of how Europe moved in the world. When they initiated this process of slavery that disrupted the history and the future of Africa, the white people didn't see this as the end of time. When Leopold killed 12 to 15 or more million African people just in the process of forcing Africans to work in the rubber plantations, when they killed all these Africans in what we now know as the Congo, they didn't see that as the end of time. When Europeans went into a little tiny island that initially they called something like Hispaniola, that we now know as Haiti, where there were 9 million human beings living there, so-called Indians. And after a four-year period, they had killed, they had left only 2 million left. The white people didn't see that as the end of time. But the fact is that there are no more so-called Indians left in this place called Haiti. There are no more Indians left in what they call Jamaica. Did you know that Jamaica and all these areas were initially inhabited by some people who they call Indians? But they're all wiped out. And the white people did not see this as the end of time. But today, they're all talking about the end of time, about Armageddon being upon us. And the problem is that some Africans are also caught up in this discussion talking about this representing the end of time. What is it that is causing them to have this discussion about the end of time? Perhaps it is the fact that here are white people who stole all this land that we now recognize as the United States of America, who built economies based on the enslavement of African people. We don't know how many were killed in the process of making this happen. Here they are on somebody's land, built off of genocide and slavery, riches that were stolen not only from Africans and the indigenous population here, but from poor people all around the world. And their buildings come tumbling down. It must be the end of time. September 11th must be something like the end of time to white people who've lived so comfortably, so secure, watching everybody else on the earth die to enrich them. Die to enrich them, and they could never talk about the end of time. It's not the end of time because all of these Africans in Congo died. It's not the end of time. It's not the end of time because 98% of the so-called Indians died throughout America. That's not the end of time. But bring down the buildings here. You have a beginning of a discussion about the end of time. Apocalypse now. Armageddon must be before us. Isn't that something? You're not looking at, when you look at America and Western imperialism, what you are looking at is an entity. The European nation that defined itself through Christianity.
Yes.
It is good. George Bush stood up and said, they hate us because we are good and they are evil. They are good. Everything, they represent everything good.
Yes.
Even in the middle of killing everybody, you know, sometimes people like to pretend to us that when we see what America's doing in places like Iraq, they say, oh, that's just a bad thing, but that's just American idealism going astray, they tell us. But what I want to tell you is that there has never been a lost innocence here. There has never been a time that America didn't know what it was doing, that white people didn't know what America was doing. Didn't they know that the Indians were being killed? Who was killing them? White people were killing them. Was no Rockefeller, was no ruling class, ordinary white people went out and killed them and murdered them and took their land and built their houses on it. Wasn't the end of time when that was happening. Was no end of time then. And so you have a situation, all the white people knew that was going on. They knew that they were not a native to this land. But here's the problem that you have. Did they know about Jim Crow? Did they know about lynching? Hell yes, they knew about lynching. Lynchings were mass affairs. These were major events that white people went and took. They took their children, took the old folks, and everybody watched. Let's go out and watch the Negro be killed.
Yeah.
And if we're lucky, we get a souvenir. We get a finger or a toe. We get a sexual organ and what have you. Literally thousands of white people came out and watched this. No lost innocence here. Wasn't the end of time when they were doing that. But the end of time seems to be upon them. And why was there no end of time? Because they were Christians. And because their Christianity is what sent them out in the first place to kill the Indians. They went out to civilize the people, the so-called Indians here.
Yes.
The Pope gave them permission to engage in slavery. It was their Christianity that did them, that held them together. Their goodness. It was their goodness that killed the Indians.
Oh, yes.
It was their goodness that got them involved in slavery. It was their goodness that got them involved in lynching African people in this country. It's their goodness that did that. It was their goodness. And this is, so you have the situation. The same Bible that sent them out to do these things, that saw them acquire wealth and saw them acquire freedom, and as a consequence of doing these things, is the same Bible that taught them about Armageddon, about the end of time, about the chaos that would reign at the end of time. Was no chaos when they were killing Africans in the Congo. Was no chaos when they were lynching Africans here. Was no chaos when they were disrupting civilization in Africa. Now they can see chaos because they are being affected and they cannot see their own future clearly. Must be the end of time. Must be the end of time. And like I said, unfortunately, even some Negroes think they're looking at the end of time. When they see this and they can point to it, they talk about wars unending. Must be the end of time, because the Bible said that at the end of time you would have wars like this.
Yes.
And so you got Africans who have no sense of ourselves, no sense of our own identity, who assume, who accept for themselves the definition of reality and time that's been imposed on them by slavery and colonialism. The white man sees the end of time, and they see the end of time as well.
Yes.
Because their time is the white man's time.
Yes.
Because their future is the white man's future.
Come on.
And if the white man has no more time, and the white man has no more future, then they have no time, and no future. Must be the end of time.
Come on. Yes. Yes. Yes.
And the end of time that they're looking at is that what they're really seeing is the end of the white man's time. That what they're looking at is the end of the time of imperialism, the end of the time of colonialism. That's what the end of time. And as it's an end of time for white power, it is a new beginning for black power. That's what they're looking at. And that's what we are working to build today. That's what our participation in this whole world is to bring about a renaissance, to bring about a resurrection, the redemption of Africa, to talk about a new beginning. This new beginning spells doom for imperialism, spells doom for white power.
Yes.
Must be the end of time.
Yes.
We're working to make it the end of time.
Yes.
And that's what it is that we're about. So we're not concerned about this end of time. They don't scare us with this notion of this being the end of time. It's about recognizing that you have a white nation that was built at the expense of everybody else. All the time that white people got, they stole it. Yes. All the time they got, they stole it. They have no innocent time. And whose time did they steal? They stole your time. Yes. The fact that you live in this country 7 years less than white people is stolen time. The fact that you have Africans who are living in places like Sierra Leone to be only 37 years old, that's stolen time. The fact that you got Indians in this country who only live to be in their 40s is stolen time. All the time they got has been stolen time. White man, this is the end of time. This is the end of time. And so that's what we're building now. We're building a future for ourselves. And this is the future that can only be constructed at the expense of what white power has built for itself, at the time that it has given for itself, the time that it has stolen for itself, the days that it has taken for itself. Without that, it wouldn't have any time. Without us, it wouldn't have any days. So we've taken our time back. We've taken our days back in the time. In the time. And so we just have to be careful, as we say, not to accept the contradiction of imperialism as our own. Ain't my problem. You heard the joke. Lone Ranger Tonto riding across the west. You heard the joke, didn't you? And they're heading in the east. And up there they see a whole bunch of so-called Indians. They turn around and say, Tonto, let's go the other way. Turn around and head to the west. And in the back of them in the west is a whole bunch of Indians. They go north and south. They run into the same problem. Isn't that something? And then Lone Ranger looks at Tonto and says, well, Tonto, looks like this is the end for us. Tonto said, us white man? Us white man? Oh, no. So it's the end of that time. Yeah. I'm not accepting that time anymore.
Oh, no.
I ain't riding with Kemosabe no more.
Oh, no.
Kemosabe on his own.